Hello everyone, I'm VBA-san. First, let's open Outlook and check out the test email we will be using. Each of these emails has a text file attachment that we will use for testing the download process. On my desktop, I have a folder named Outlook VBA. I have already set up a macro to download attachments directly into this folder. I select 5 emails, test 1 to test 5, then click the macro button labeled Fixed Path. This time, only selecting test 5 and test 3 worked perfectly as well. Now, let me show you how to choose a download path via a pop-up window. This time, I click Select Path button, and a folder browsing window will appear, allowing you to select the path where you want the attachments to be downloaded. If I select the desktop directly, there's no issue either. This folder browsing window allows you to select local paths or network paths, and you can also manually type in the path. It's super convenient. Now, let's take a look at how to set up the code. First, you need to enable the Developer tab. Go to File, Options, Customize Ribbon. Find Developer on the right side and check the box, then click OK. After that, the Developer tab will appear in Outlook. Next, click Visual Basic. Right-click on Project 1 and choose Insert Module. Now, go to the description box of this video. Copy the code from the comments section and return to the VBA editor. Delete the first line, then paste the copied code, save it, and you're good to go. Now, let's test it. Click on Macros, and you will see two options, Fixed Path and Select Path. Feel free to try it yourself. You'll get the same result as I did earlier. Next, let me show you how to change the download folder for the Fixed Path. In the VBA editor, go to Fixed Path, and you'll see the Save Folder command. After the equal sign, you will find the path in double quotes. You can change it to any path you like. You can even use network paths. But remember to add a backslash at the end of the path. Otherwise, the program may not work properly. Finally, let me show you how to add the macro to a button on the ribbon. Go to File, Options, Customize Ribbon, Developer, then click the New Group button, Rename button. Now you can rename this group and assign an icon to it. I name my group VBA. Now select macros on the left and add both options to the new VBA group on the right. Once you're finished, you will see the two buttons appear on the ribbon in Outlook. I forgot to mention, you can also rename the buttons. Just go to Rename and change the display name to whatever you like. That's all for today. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. In the next few videos, I will continue with more Outlook-related contents. So stay tuned. I'm VBA-san. Thanks for watching.